I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, helping you make your game nights better by doing things like telling you what you get in the box with this. In this unboxing video, I will be opening up Terraforming Mars Ares Expedition from Stronghold Games. This is the game that happens when Race for the Galaxy and Terraforming Mars have a baby. This is an action selection game, but also a tech tree-based tableau builder. With a smaller map of Mars, it's all the joy of the 3 to 6 hour game of Terraforming Mars distilled down into, it says an hour, I'd say a little more than that based on what I've seen. This was a gift that I received for my birthday, so I appreciate the gift. This is not a review copy or anything like that. I am a huge fan of Terraforming Mars. I've been wanting to try this game out for a long time. Note this says collector's edition. Sorry, it's over here. It's actually a sticker on here. As far as I can tell, there's no non-collector's edition of this game. If there is one out there, I apologize if I'm wrong, but like the copies I've seen for sale at online stores and our friendly local game store are all been the collector's edition. So I don't know if there is a non-collector's edition of this. But anyway, I am looking forward to playing this game, possibly even this weekend. So step one is going to be cutting the shrink and opening up this box. Now, I have done a demo of this game at Origins Game Fair 2023, so I do have some idea of the components, but I have not actually seen inside my particular copy, nor have I seen a box opened up. So there may be stuff in here, I don't know what it is, and there may be some surprises. So join me as I open up Terraforming Mars Ares Expedition Deluxe Edition. Sorry, there's UV spot coating on here that I didn't notice, and I'm just like, my hand went along the edge. And I felt it. I'm like, what is that? What's sticky? But it's, there's just a little bit like on the text here, on the people, but it's not like enough to, you can kind of see it there. I didn't even notice it. It's so subtle. Anyway, that's not the important part. So here we have the box for Terraforming Mars Ares Expedition, the Terraforming Mars card game, if you will. Terraform for the Galaxy. Race for Mars is what I like to call it. Showing off the different sides of the box here. Do dig the wraparound art. That's always kind of cool. And I will show off the back here that just kind of bunch of cards. And look, it's a map of Mars. Let's show off what's inside. That's the important part. Terraforming Mars. Ooh, texture. We have a linen finished book. Again, this is the deluxe ability, I guess. Deluxe edition. Oh, that is a nice rule. Rub the rule book. Happy rule book. That is nice. I haven't touched a rule book that nice since, Tapestry from Stonemaier Games. Overview, looking at the components, we're going to flip through those. So you're going to see most of those. Showing the various game board, you'll note it's much smaller than the usual. You're looking at your different card types here in the card anatomy, including things like tags. If you played Terraforming Mars, it's all going to look very familiar. The player boards, which is one of the highlights here, they are dual layer boards, quite simplified compared to the Terraforming Mars ones. You have your resources as well as other tokens. Oh, it's so nice. Feels so pretty. Showing you how to do the setup. This is one of the better setups I've seen where it kind of shows you do this, then this with arrows. But it's odd because it starts at 1 and 2. But it's nice. Lots of white space. I like how this is spread out. Showing the different things you're going to plan, you're going to resolve, and you're going to do stuff. There are different phases. Playing project cards is very similar to the previous game. This is showing all the various action phases. A symbology summary. Again, the symbols are actually identical to Terraforming Mars. So that's appreciated because anyone who knows the game. Rules, though, 16 pages. Now we're going to, well, overview is important. Yeah, we'll say 14 pages of rules, which is not an insignificant amount. And two-player co-op mode. I did not know that was in here, so that's cool to see. I appreciate that. Co-op is something you could do in the original. No, I know you can do solo, so solo play as well. This is a nice-looking book. Oh, nice game overview on the back. Thank you. And I don't know how to listen to it. It's got a texture. It's a really nice texture. Oh, look at this. Quick start guide. We talk on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast about onboarding. This is nice. Look at that. Everything's here. It's just quick setup. It's on page 8 if you need the reference. End of setup. End step. Wow. Oh, this is nice. This is really nice. Even has a co-op and solo. That is a nice touch. That bonus points, Stronghold Games. Dual layer boards. Not warped at all. Always good to see. You can kind of see it. Your cubes are going to slot in and move over. And then you have your 10, 20s, 30s. And then your big group to gather your resources. It simplified. It shows how much to buy your basic things. Because again, the basic game is almost the same. Spend $20 to buy a tree, 14 to raise the temperature, or 8 trees to build a tree. Like your basic mechanics are very similar to the original. And while we have these for all the players, nice. Those are nice. Those are some of the nicest dual layer boards I've seen. That is the main board. That's it for space. So there we have our different things, and you've got your various tracking. You've got, I got it upside down. Well, so you have the temperature gauge and you have the oxygen gauge. You have the mega credit around the outside. And this is, it's what you have. Then we have the tiles. So one of the things, the big change here from Terraforming Mars is every turn you're going to decide what you want to do. If you want to develop, construct, you want to take an action, you want to do production or research. Then you reveal that, and depending on what phases people picked, you may not get some. So some games you may not be able to, or some turns you may not do any research, or you may not develop, or everyone will choose construction. That's all you do. As usual, you get a bonus for being the leader. Everyone else still gets to do the action, though. That's the race for the galaxy component of this. Then we have our various trees and water tokens. Interesting. I'm assuming they left lots of room for either an expansion or for sleeving cards, because it's got the foam blocks, which I do appreciate when you don't give me a full component or a full list. Over here, though, we have the cubes in the four-player colors, which have not changed. They are plastic. Again, if you play Terraforming Mars, this is no different. I'm just going to hold that. I'm not going to bother unbagging that. No, I'll take one out. So yeah, plastic cubes in the four-player colors, which the reason I decided to take one out is so I can grab one of these boards just to show how well they slot in. We're going to slot it in there. Oh, it's in there. Some jostling's okay, but if you get a good bump on the board, it's not going to help you too much. I got to say, it's better than nothing. It's better than no recessed. These ones are nice. No, but I know this because I did a demo and I got to play with these boards. The offset's an interesting way to do it. It works, just it's not 100%. It's better than nothing. Corporation cards should also be rule summaries. Oh, no, these are dividers. Awesome. Very cool. Look at that. Though I got to wonder if I put the playing board on top of that, isn't that going to bend these? So, yes, I'm just slotting those in. But for cardboard box inserts, that's nice. So, yeah, player aid cards look very solid, very comprehensive. Trays and more trays. Again, technically, this is the deluxe edition. I have never seen a non-deluxe. So here is a change from the original game. And I got to say, this looks fine. You don't get the metallic cubes. Instead, we have plastic ones in the various colors. So you have copper now, is now plastic, copper colored, which to me is an advantage because the originals, many people complained about chipping. And we've got silver. And I know these are going to get split this way, and it's just so that different players can reach. And here is the other awesome thing about these. If you can't, I don't know if you can tell on the camera, they are different sizes. So that is a great help with accessibility, that the silver is small, or sorry, the copper is smaller than the silver, which is smaller than the gold. The gold's nice and chunky and feels like, hey, I've got something important here. Then there's also two clear cubes. Those are for tracking or terraforming level. So there, nice, inserted. I didn't split those very evenly, but we're not here to actually sort my game. I just figured why not do this at the same time. So two different trays for your resources. Additional baggies. I'm not sure. Well, there's the player boards in that. I don't see a big reason for the additional baggies. So all we've got left at this point is the cards. So what I'm just doing is kind of organizing some of this other stuff back in here. Not sure why all the extra huge baggies. Oh, the tiles. Once you punch the tiles. Yeah, I guess they're just going to end up loose in there. All right, cards. It's It's Terraforming Mars. You expect a nice, big, thick deck. There's going to be some other stuff in here, but I'm guessing at least these two are probably the main core deck of the game. Yeah, these should be in player color. So red player, yellow player, green player, blue player, and all these are? What action do you want to take? Put it face down on the table. Everyone reveal. That's the phase you're going to act in. You have the ability and then the bonus. If you are the player who actually plays development, you pay 3 less. I'm not going to bother showing off the other colors because they're literally identical. It's 4 of the same deck. Here we have corporations. As you can tell, for any fans of Terraforming Mars, this is much simpler. This one is you start with 3 heat and so on. Different corporations, starting tags in the corner. No art, really, except for a logo, if you look, they're all the same background. But you know what? The important information is huge, which I greatly appreciate. I would rather have more information and less art. Cards. Oh, make sure you shuffle, because they're very sorted. It's what they cost, tags they have, what they give you. This is going to up your production, right? Now, I know there's a lot of controversy over the Terraforming Mars artwork. It is going to be a mix of stock artwork, work that has been redone by the Fricks brothers and so on. I am not going to comment on the artwork other than to just show some of it off. Personally, it seems more uniform than Terraforming Mars was. And I am guessing these are just going to be way more cards. So one of the differences in this one is to use your blue cards, you have to take that blue action. Tags are a lot clearer than on the original card design. Look at them all. Just tons of cards. It's exactly what I expect from a Terraforming Mars game, is a massive development. Maybe they're called developments. I feel bad that I don't remember the name of the cards, but I think this may be more than the base game of Terraforming Mars even comes with. Look, lots and lots of cards. What I'm not seeing is any like Venus tags or any of those weird ones. The unusual ones from some of the expansions. Tons of cards. That is a massive flipping deck of cards. Look at that. It's huge. Since I have dividers, let's see if I use them effectively here. Project cards. There we go. So we're going to put a piece of foam here, and we're going to put phase cards in front. Ugh. Except it felt, it's terrible. And then behind the phase cards, I'm going to put the reference cards. Nope. Forgot they're bigger than. Then I'm going to put the corporation cards. Then I'm going to put foam, and then I'm going to put the project cards, which honestly, with the foam, I don't really need the dividers, obviously. Man, that's a deck. Wow. There is enough give there. I do not sleeve my cards. I play unprotected. I think there's enough room for sleeve cards there. Yeah, the only reason this is going to be a problem is because I haven't punched these. Because, look, they'll sit on this side, won't they? No. Yeah, it's an odd choice to have these stick up when you're putting stuff back in the box. That might be worth a Google to see if there's a better way. So what I'm going to do is just forget the dividers right now so that everything sits flat. I'm just going to slide these to the very end where they can just get pushed up against the edge for putting everything back. There you go. What you get. Terraforming Mars, Ares Expedition Collector's Edition, which I still think might be the only edition out there. Awesome looking dual layer boards. They work pretty well. They're better than just the thin one. One of the things I got to say is they're thick, at least. They're nice player mats. The original Terraforming Mars mats are very thin. basically sheets of paper, the tokens for your different phases that you can act in. Much, in my opinion, improved resource cubes by being actually plastic and colored copper, silver, and gold instead of being painted. Wooden cubes, plus they're all different size, which makes them more accessible. The copper is actually smaller than the gold. So that's actually a nice touch. I do appreciate that. Comes with some trays for those as well. Nice looking game. Artwork looks more cohesive than the original Terraforming Mars, which to me is a bonus. I am looking forward to trying this out. I love Terraforming Mars. I love Race for the Galaxy. Race for the Galaxy is my most played board game of all time. Terraforming Mars would be, but it takes way too long sometimes. So I am really looking forward to checking this out. When I do, I will be sharing my thoughts on social media, where you can find me everywhere as Tabletop Bellhop, one word. You can also find me at tabletopbellhop.com. That is our website and blog, where you can find other game reviews, unboxings, and answers to your game and game night questions. If you've got a question for me, consider me a Dear Abby for gamers. You can send that to questions@tabletopbellhop.com, and we'll answer those on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice. Thank you for joining me on this short trip to Mars for Terraforming Mars Ares Expedition